Hallo en welkom hier so by Farm Space. Welcome to Farm Space. We're in the English area today, nee. Okay, so we're going to speak to Craig. He does regenerative farming and he's got this inline ripper. Okay, so going to tell us exactly where this fits into his farm and so forth. Ja, inline ripper, nee. Hier's nog ene. Ons gaan 'n bietjie deurwerk. Presies hoe gebruik hy die ding en so voort. So, kom ons luister. Craig, how are you doing?
I'm fine and you, Chippy?
No, I'm good, thanks. Okay, so you're here in the Mooirivier area.
Yes.
Quickly explain to me a little bit about how does your farming operation work? What do you do? What do you cultivate primarily? And then we can get to where this thing fits in.
Okay, so we grow maize for silage and for grain.
Yeah.
We feed cattle yeah, we do got a small feedlot here,
do I understand you correctly, it's primarily maize that you actually grow. Yes. Do you go into the into other crops, wheat, those types of things, or just predominantly maize, and there are then just some let's call it cover crops and I don't want to get the, what do you call, weiding?
Forage.
Yeah, you see, my English is already up. Nay. So the forage crops that you also put in, am I correct?
So we just do cover crops, rotate lands every now and then, but primarily we want to try and grow maize year on year, but then put a cover crop in with it and just have a growing root all year round.
Awesome. So am I correct in saying that the cover crops, especially when you're looking at the legumes and stuff like that, that basically brings almost the same as which other guy would go, like maize, soya, so having that rotation between a grass and a legume, where you then basically bring that into your system and that basically gives you that component?
It's hard to get legumes to work with maize because you generally get a flood on and you don't get a good take trying to get a legume to grow. We'd rather pull out a block and then plant a cover crop, two cover crops for a season.
Yeah.
And then go back to maize.
100%. Okay. And then obviously that with the regenerative farming, if you're looking at this block here, you don't want to, the way that I understand it, till the soil too much or disturb the soil in terms of turning it around and so forth. Mm. Is that where this ripper comes in?
So we want to try and not damage the structure of the soil as much as possible. So the problem I think most farmers have never really ripped deep enough, and we've been going ripping as deep as a hard pan and not going through it, and so a lot of the thinking in America is to rip deep, get the oxygen down, and then to do a shallow cultivation at the top and just make a seed bed and plant into that.
But am I also correct in saying that that's also a cultivation that doesn't need to happen every year? You don't need to loosen it up.
No.
Every single year, once every 2 or 3 years, that should be sufficient.
Yeah, I think so. We're still new. I've only had it 1 year.
Yeah.
But the first thing I've noticed is that where we have ripped, we've got no runoff anymore. There's no erosion. The water runs in and not running off with the soil. And that for me is a huge
especially here where you are. I mean, that's important because yes, here in East Kainstis,
yeah.
It's downhill from here. If I don't know if I can put it, if I can get in waterpas here, you can see this.
There's not one piece of flat ground on this farm.
Jy boer tussen die berge en die dale, né?
Yeah.
Okay, so then you started looking for you say about a year ago, so started looking for an inline ripper. Okay. Yes. So how did you decide on the Karatek?
So I looked overseas at a lot of rippers there, and I actually looked at Unverwerth, and this, I didn't realize that Monotech actually imported the components from Unverwerth, and then they build the frame here and then bolt the Unverwerth components on, and this is basically what it is. The thing I liked about it is that it's got a trip mechanism. It trips at 1,500 kgs.
And this is basically these cylinders that works here. So is that like a type of a closed hydraulic springs? What is in here?
It's just a spring.
So it's like this. Let me just quickly. So it's basically the same almost as that spring.
Yes.
But you've got two springs that's in there.
So I think it's designed to trip and then it pulls itself back in. So you don't have to stop when you're driving. If it trips, you just keep going and it pulls itself back in.
And in terms of then loosening the soil properly, because I mean that's something that we've seen now is with these inline rippers that it actually breaks the soil from time to time properly.
Yes.
So you don't get those let's call it those shallow pockets that shallow at the top. You get that formation in the ground. You basically get a better breakage in the soil. Was that your experience?
Yes, it breaks the soil beautifully. You know, there are other rippers in the market and they all do a good job, but you know, this is what I decided to go for and I'm very happy with the results.
And the cutters that you've got in the front, do they work properly in terms of cutting through the material and not getting those big clots you get at the end of the day?
No, it does a very neat job. Very few clots coming up. Obviously the drier and the harder it is, it does get a bit rougher, but after a rain like we've had now, it'll do a beautiful job.
Awesome. But okay, so you've got your penetrometer there. I mean, let's put it in and then let's see, let it go through a little bit and let's take the penetrometer and see what we see. Okay, so we've pulled it through here. This is not the ideal conditions. I mean, it's not like you will be ripping now because you had what, 70, 80 millimeters with the past 2 days. So it's very wet, and I told you now I'll be very impressed if it breaks through still. But show me there what it looks like.
Mm,
I mean, goes through easily. And let's go a little bit nearer to the tine because that's now right smack in between the tines. There it goes through. And I mean, even in these conditions, you're happy with the breakup, eh?
It's a big hit the nut for me. Yeah, I feel like if I'm a bit uitdroog. I feel like as ons môre begin is better.
Yeah, dan sal hy nou actually better werk dat jy hom mooi kan deurkry. But I mean, it's still breaking up the soil properly.
Yeah.
Even in these conditions.
Yeah.
And then on the other kant wat ek gou weer wil hoor, nê, is hierdie wear parts en al hierdie goede wat hier op is, nê? Want dis een van die klagtes wat ek by baie van die ouens kry. Hulle sê ja, die inline rippers werk, maar die wear parts is 'n probleem. Hulle wear vinnig uit. Wat is jou ervaring op hom?
Hy hou nie baie lank nie, maar ek sit bietjie swys op hom en hy hou langer.
So basically net by een van daai Ek noem hulle altyd die blou rods. Yes. Nee. Yeah. Ek weet nie wat noem hulle die goed actually nie.
Hardening.
Ja, hardening rods, hard so you just do that and then it lasts longer.
Ja, yeah, so as hy begin eet, ek haal hom af, sit nog 'n nuwe stel op en ja, hy gaan tot hy begin bietjie eet en ja, gaan
en dan sê hy vir my nee, want and then in terms of replacing the wear parts, how difficult is that?
Ja, is baie maklik. Jy haal net daai rolpin uit en die hele ding val af en
sit jy hom net weer terug en dan gaan jy.
Ja, is vat 'n minuut per arm per tand. Ja.
En sê gou vir my in terme van met jou boerdery die afgelope jaar wat jy die goeders deurgetrek het, watse verskil dink jy het hierdie implement in jou boerdery gemaak?
Die grootste ding wat ek gesien het is in die droë periode, my mielies het baie minder gesukkel.
So baie minder stres gehad
en daai en daai en die water kan wegloop as dit te veel is.
Diens en daai tipe van goed?
As pyk. Ons gebruik Moimac wat naby aan ons is en hulle het al die onderdele en hulle diens is ongelooflik. Hulle maak oop vir jou enige tyd as jy hulle mooi vra.
Ek sê altyd as jy met 'n nuwe ou begin besigheid doen in boerdery, nê? Jy sê hom niks nie, dan al wat jy doen is jy bel hom 4:15 op 'n Vrydagmiddag. Net om hom te toets. As hy die telefoon antwoord, dan weet jy nie, sjap.
Wel, hulle maak oop op 'n Sondag. As jy mooi vra.
And but you see that's at the end of the day what you need because as jy hulle kyk boerdery wag, die belangrikste ding is jy moet doen wat gedoen moet word, wanneer dit gedoen moet word, ja. As die kalf in die put is, dan moet hy uit.
Ja.
And if you've got a company like that that stands behind you, then that's reassuring.
Ja, alles, ja, dis die hoofrede hoekom ek hierdie masjien gekoop het, is want hulle diens is so goed.
Right, so, dit is Kruik hierso van Mooi Rivier se area. Okay. So, daai Manotech inline ripper, daar's vir jou nog 'n opsie hierso. So jy kan sien, hy werk definitief penetrometer deurgetrek en is regtig nat kondisies hierdie, nê. Dink as hy bietjie ideaal is, 'n bietjie droër is, gaan hy hom actually net nog beter breek. So, linkie bo of hieronder, kan jy met hulle in kontak kom. Dis iemand van Spice af. Tot volgende keer. Groete.